but the dreaming.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Whoa.
Bye.
Whoa.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
So. Hopefully the music doesn't cause a problem. I'm gonna be very irritated if it does.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Where's Valentine?
Next time I have to watch someone's life story, I want popcorn.
Well, if you're cognizant enough to joke, I think we can safely say that you're out of critical condition. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute. Virgil, that scientist who escaped.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. This changes everything. He could answer all sorts of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That can't be right. No one would risk going there, not even to hide.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation and the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak, a way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive,
I'm assuming the teleportation doesn't penetrate radiation too well.
If you're going to follow him.
Oh, I'm going in naked. Fingers crossed I get superpowers.
I know you're joking, but as a doctor, I feel obligated to remind you that unprotected radioactive exposure will only kill you. Dead. D-E-A-D. So be sure you find a way to get through there with your life intact. And good luck. By the way,
well,
I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Remove the implant while you were waking up.
I'd bought that radiation suit, or hazmat suit. And I've got Radix. I could possibly survive the glowing sea. But I kind of want to investigate the Brotherhood first. Mr. Valentine. How you doing?
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. That was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Nick, are you still in there?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
I'm gonna head out on my own from here, Nick.
Good luck out there. You know where to find me.
Indeed I do, sir. Indeed I do. However, I mean, I would be worried about the dog, but I watched it take a swim through a radioactive lake earlier, so I don't know what to think anymore.
Whoever this Brotherhood of Steel is.
Are you wearing a wig?
We come in peace, malarkey.
Hey, Daisy. I was out by.
Speaking of the We Come in Peace malarkey. Investigate the Brotherhood of Steel airship. Am I on the wrong side of town? I might be on the wrong side of town. I definitely am.
Don't have no handouts.
Nice police uniform you've got there.
We freaks gotta stick together, and the best way to stick together is to keep an eye out for what drives us apart. You feel me?
Yeah, you tell it like it is, Hancock!
Now, what out there in our big friendly commonwealth would want to drive us apart? What kind of twisted, unneighborly boogeyman would want to hurt our peaceful community?
The Institute and their sins!
That's right. Who said that? Coming up to my office later. You've earned yourself some jet. The Institute. They're the real enemy. Not the Raiders. Not the super mutants. Not even those tools over in Diamond City.
I don't know, Hancock! I'd sure love to give McDonough a kick in the ass!
Hey, We all know I got my own personal beef with that lardhead. Let's stay focused. Now, I want everyone to keep the Institute in mind. When someone starts acting funny, when people are doing things they don't normally do, when family starts pushing you away for no reason, we all know who's behind that kind of shit. And the only way to stop it is to stick together. They can't control us if we're not afraid. Now, who's scared of the Institute?
Not us!
And which town in the Commonwealth should the Institute not fuck with?
Good Neighbor!
And who's in charge of Good Neighbor?
Of the people! For the people!
Whoa.
The Hotel Rexford's got rooms for rent.
So, it seems that whenever, where's the actual exit? I got distracted. Yeah. It seems that whenever everything goes to hell in a handbasket on the East Coast, suddenly everything starts going back to colonization of the United States by the British forces. You know, and the things done by the Founding Fathers of America. So, they do say history will repeat itself, although this place seems to have a pirate in lead of it. Then again, that might actually be the same style of hat as what was just worn back then. I haven't looked into it too much. I'm sure somebody will complain that, you know, I don't know enough about history or something, but meh. It might repeat itself, but it's never exactly the same. Okay, just die, would you? Just die. Please? Okay. Dead. Good. Do I have any? No. I'll just eat some corn. Waff down some squirrel bits. Zombies. I'm gonna have to mess with raiders now too, aren't I? Oh, speaking of which. Oh, jeez. Oh, God. Whew. Oh, shut up. Quit whining. Grenade. Poisoners, huh? Meh. Okay. There's something over in that one direction which is causing me some nasty frame rate lag. That away, I think? This way's actually even worse. Bye-bye. Oh, it's just a turret. I can't be bothered. Okay. Let's use this. Let's go see about this whole Brotherhood situation. And, you know what? I mean, purified water. Oh, yeah. Some nice, delicious water. Haven't experienced that in 210 years. How do I get to the other side of the water? Because clearly swimming is not an option. I mean, I'm assuming this water is radioactive. Oh, yeah. I could swim it. I've got plenty of red X. Is it worth it, though? No. Looks like there might be a bridge over there. Oh. But how do I... Against my better judgment. Oh, what? Where? What'd you find? Red X, pulse mine, ammo. What? Fine. Take the pulse mine if it makes you happy. What? Good dog? 45 caliber rounds? Oh, yeah. So you do 22 damage and you do 18 damage. So. Oops. Even on a per shot basis, you are better. See you on the other side, dog meat. Oh yeah, one rat away should be plenty enough. Oh yeah. I mean, I lose a little bit of health, but whoop-de-doo. Actually, I know how to deal with the fact that I lost a little bit of health. Bam. Pure water. Boston Airport. I'm almost leveled up again. That's pretty fantastic, actually. Tell you what, I'm pretty glad that Dogmeat found me this gun. Because I've been wanting something that uses 45 rounds that's not terrible. Tell you what, I'll put my gun away. However, I will shoot them. I swear to God.
This area is off limits to civilians. I order you to stand down and tell me what you're doing here immediately.
On whose authority?
By the authority of Elder Arthur Maxon, Supreme Commander of the Brotherhood of Steel. Now I'll repeat my question. What are you doing here?
I was hoping to track down the owners of that huge airship.
Well, you found us. And since this is a military installation, this is the closest you're going to get to her.
I'm no stranger to these installations. My husband was in the military.
Really? Well then, you might just be in luck. With your experience, you might actually fit in with the Brotherhood. We're always looking to add a few more brothers and sisters to our ranks. If
really?
You think you have what it takes.
Will it get me aboard that airship?
If you live long enough to make the rank of knight, you'll have full access. Head over to the Cambridge police station and look for Paladin Dance. He's in charge of our new recruits, and I'm certain he'll be glad to have an extra gun on his team. Ad Victorium, civilian.
I don't know.
And good luck.
Honestly. Fine. What's going on here with my quest information? That says to go there. What are you wearing?
Take off, civilian.
Do you not understand? I will shoot people. I swear, I will get on that airship if I have to shoot my way in. Although I'm torn between trying to be, you know, this, like, basically a mercenary type thing, and at the same time, I want to know everything. But then again, I can only assume that every door that is open is closed. Every door that is opened becomes a closed door somewhere else. Although, they do a very good job of providing choice. People tend to do what they do, but if something is brought up that they find is more interesting, they're provided an option to switch. Once. I mean, Skyrim gave you that option. I mean, look at the, you could switch sides at a certain point during the war in Skyrim. What are you doing, dog meat? Okay. Gained experience. So, what do I want to do with this experience? Level 25. That would be useful. You know what? I want rank 2 armor mods. I like the mod system, it's fun. Hey there, how you doing? Zombies. Really? Oh, crap.
I heard something.
Bottle cap. Empty, pencil, empty, shotgun shells, bottle cap, hairbrush, baseball.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
Pest exterminator, I heard you had a feral problem.
Evading my questions is a surefire way of getting yourself ejected from the compound. Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Vault 111.
You're a vault dweller? Most people wouldn't admit to such a thing. I appreciate your honesty.
I probably shouldn't have, but you know what? I don't care.
It's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue...
Let me guess.
We could use an extra gun on our side.
That all depends. How much are you paying?
We need allies, not opportunistic mercenaries. I have no inclination to pay for your services.
I want to help, but I don't like the secrecy. Who are you really?
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. I've been trying to send a distress call to our vessel at Boston International Airport, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need, the deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? Are you willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
Fine. Oh, I really want to be sarcastic, but then he might just turn me down.
It's a good plan. If we make it back.
I can assure you that I wouldn't undertake this mission unless I had confidence in your abilities.
But you don't even know me. How could you have confidence? I mean, besides the, you know, horde of zombies we just fought off. You know, besides that.
Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin.
The door's not open.
Out, people.
All right, big guy. Let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Okay. So, question. I wasn't paying attention. How long has this quest been available? Because I thought I had something that told me to go to the police station before the Brotherhood rolled in. He told me to resupply. I mean, I'll be honest. At this point, he's basically paying me up front. Things like stim packs? They alone are a pretty good payment.
I don't know. Your prognosis looks pretty grim. Might be more humane to just take you out back and shoot you.
You're all heart, Doc.
Just quit squirming so I can get these bandages on.
Fan. Like, seriously. Right away in stim packs. Take those. Actually, I'll take that, too. Burnt through a lot of my adhesive. I don't know what's actually in turpentine, but I'll take it. I'll take that, too, because I can.
Think you're some kind of hotshot?
What? Oh, that was rat poison. I thought it looked like buff out at first. What? Oh, hello.
Nice.
Bobby pin, frag grenades, frag mine, jet, rad X, stealth boy. Oops, stealth boy. And you know what? I'll take the fork. Really? There's no Nuka-Cola? Oh, well. Doesn't heal that well in this game anyhow. I don't know why, but I keep expecting, like, unique outfits. Like, I saw a guy actually wearing a police uniform, so I expected a police uniform to show up inside this building. And again, it looks like there's still a downstairs. Thank you, goodbye. Wait, yeah. No, never mind. That was the entrance. Is that everything? I think that be everything. Okay.
Yes. You ready to move out?
Yeah. Why the police
Why
station?
Why establish an outpost at the police station?
Given the nature of the facility, we felt it would be tactically advantageous to search it for weapons and ammunition. The radio tower on the roof was an unexpected boon, but it obviously has its shortcomings that need to be rectified. It might not be as imposing as the Citadel back in the Capital Wasteland, but it suits our purposes. That's all I'm willing to divulge at this point. Are you ready to proceed with the mission?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind.
T-60? The last one I knew of was, I think, T-51B? This bug is slightly annoying. What's going on here? There we go. Doors can be weird sometimes. Doors can be weird. I'm gonna be honest. I'm actually kind of hoping the Enclave show up and I can actually join them. Follow me. Where's Dogmeat?
Arc Jet is a short hike to the west. If we take this road, we should be able to avoid the larger packs of ferals infesting Cambridge. Traveling this far from the police station is a risk, but getting that transmitter up and running needs to be our top priority. If it was up to me, I'd relocate my team. But Scribe Halen detected some disturbing energy readings in the area that need to be investigated.
Really?
I don't know much about them, except that they're short-lived and broadcast on a frequency only attainable with a high level of technology.
Sounds like Institute.
But whoever or whatever is creating those energy readings might be a potential threat. So it's our job to investigate.
Threat, huh? To you or everybody, I wonder? Yeah, chill out. I loot things. It's what I do.
We may have a problem. It might surprise you to learn that my recon team isn't the first to visit the Commonwealth. Over the last 7 years, two other teams were sent here by the Brotherhood to gather technology. The first team's mission was a huge success. They came back with crates full of pre-war artifacts and historical documents. The second wasn't so fortunate. Shortly after they arrived, we lost contact with them, and they haven't been heard from since. As far as my team goes, we've lost 4 good men to this godforsaken wasteland.
We've
been a target from the moment we arrived. But despite our setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home. Or end up missing.
Well, with what the Commonwealth can do, or the Institute can do, I can only assume that they were possibly abducted, and then they were possibly somehow basically controlled to diverge information about the Brotherhood of Steel and whatnot, or other various things. So, the Institute probably has it out for you, and don't want you to get a foothold because of what you do as a faction. But I say that like my character should actually know what the Brotherhood as a faction is, and this is also 10 years after what we really know about the Brotherhood. So at this point, these could actually be the Capital Wasteland Brotherhood that try to make the communities better but are still complete hard asses. Why is there a vertebrate over there? Why is there a vertebrate over there? Why was there? Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna just let you deal with that. Fine. Since you clearly suck at your job, which is clearly the reason why you brought me along. You know, all the things have such high quality textures. I feel like the Pip-Boy could have been slightly better. Just texture-wise. I'm sure somebody will make a texture mod for it, make it a lot better. Okay. So.
Excuse me, Paladin Dance.
Keep moving, double time it.
Okay, fine. Yeah, whatever. I'm gonna go in and look. You can follow me, or you can stand there and be just retarded. I don't really care.
It was corporations like this that put the last nail in the coffin for mankind. They exploited technology for their own gains, pocketing the cash and ignoring the damage they've done.
This is the history of the Institute. This is Institute technology. Like, you compare it to what we saw at Kellogg's place. Like, at the very end. This is Institute technology.
It appears as though...
What? These are Protectrons. These are Robco stuff.